start by welcoming you all here, and also to thank you guys for coming. This is a great turnout, much more than I expected, actually. Other than that, welcome to the spring 2018 Dare graduation. I'd like to start by thanking Ms. Gadwa and Ms. Sutherland. Ms. Gadwa, unfortunately, couldn't be with us today. I'd also like to thank Mr. McAuliffe for allowing me to continue this curriculum in this great school. In addition, I'd like to thank Chair Favreau for allowing me to teach Dare and be in the schools as much as I could. Additionally, I would like to thank all the parents for coming to this program. My name is Deputy Terry, and I've been at Clinton County Sheriff's Office for just over 6 months. I transferred from the Lake Placid Police Department about November-ish, October-ish, and I came right into the DARE program. And it's great because, to give you a little background, I worked with children when I was in high school at a summer camp the whole time I was in high school. And when I got into law enforcement, I felt like I was doing a lot of really great work, but I felt like I was missing a component. So when I found out that this DARE program opened up, it was like the best news ever for me. So I called the Sheriff's Department and I was able to get the job as the DARE instructor, which was great for me because I feel like changing this perspective of law enforcement in the community, the narrative that's going on right now, starts with our children and our communities. So I'm really excited that I get to be a part of that. That being said, I just want to talk about how DARE is not the program that you or I went through when we were children. I know that when I went through, it was much different than it was now, and I don't know how all of you guys, how much you know about that, or if it was even different than when I went through, but today's DARE program is, instead of learning about drugs and alcohol and tobacco and the effects that they have, we're still learning about drugs and alcohol and tobacco, but we're focusing on a decision-making process that aids in the development of negative attitudes towards them and how to resist them instead of just the effects of what they do. Keeping it real is the name of that program, and it's implemented by DARE, and it focuses on decision-making, being a good citizen, responding to risky situations, responding to peer pressure and stress, communication methods, and making good choices. Recognizing the signs of bullying and reporting incidents of bullying are also the focal points of the curriculum. I spend a lot of time with my kids on bullying because I think it's such a prevalent subject in today's world. So to me, that really hits home when I make sure that the kids get not just bullying, but all of the curriculum is focused on. But bullying is one of the bigger things that I like to focus on. Technically, the DARE program consists of 10 45-minute lessons. But to me, the lessons are just the tip of the iceberg. Spending time with the kids and building relationships that they won't forget is what it's all really about for me. Our sheriff allows us to be in the school full-time, which is unique to our county. So we're able to change the narrative of what's going on between the community and law enforcement, as I said before. So building those relationships with the kids is really important to us. And like I said once before, changing the narrative between what's going on in the media, between law enforcement and the community. And fostering that narrative when they're young is great for when they grow up and then they see you on the street and it's not like they're wondering how to interact with the police or they're suspicious of the police. It's more of a nurturing relationship that they've known you since they were in fifth grade, which I think is great. Since the curriculum is so different than what you and I learned in grade school, I'd like to provide you with a couple of facts that I've found. According to the study completed by Penn State University in 2009, keeping it real is successful in decreasing substance abuse, reducing negative attitudes and behaviors towards those substances, and improving positive attitudes and behaviors in general. The data showed a 32% to a 44% reduction in marijuana, tobacco, and alcohol use. 29% to a 34% decrease in the intent to accept those substances. A 30% to a 38% increase in negative attitudes towards drug use. Now, before I go any further, I've thanked the teachers, I've thanked Mr. McAuliffe, and I've thanked the parents for coming today, but what I failed to do so far, so I failed to thank the ones who really make this whole program go round, and that's the kids. I just wanted to say thank you to all the fifth grade students at Chazy Elementary. Your enthusiasm is unmatched and genuinely makes me want to walk into this building and community every Monday. I genuinely have not seen a group of kids that are nicer to each other, more happy to be around each other. I've done this at a couple schools now, and this group is just, it's top notch. And not only does that make me genuine and enthusiastic about the program, make it great for them, makes it great for me. Like I said, I can't wait to come to school every Wednesday and to give them the lessons that I'm provided with. So it makes it a better overall experience for me. Soon, these students will be taking the next step in their lives by going to sixth grade. I'm confident that these students will be successful in this endeavor, and I'm extremely proud to have been blessed with the time that I've had with them. I cannot express how much I'm going to miss this group, from Brooke's enthusiasm, to Chris's humor, to Quinn's genuine kindness, and so many more things that I'm going to miss next year. I'll definitely miss Connor and Michael helping me win in football, making me look good at quarterback. God knows I am not good at quarterback. I'm pretty confident now, though, with that showing with Connor and Michael, that I'm going to be drafted as an undrafted free agent by Philly, hopefully. With that being said, every year there we have a essay competition, which is essentially about each student's own experience with DARE, what they've learned, how they plan to use it, and what they've done with it in their own lives, how they've applied it. The quality of the essays that we've received this year was extremely high. The essay winners were chosen by a panel of officers familiar with the program, and two winners have been selected. The essay winners have the great honor of reading their essays for you today. Now, I would like to welcome Avery Rotella and Max Addix Tyndall to the stage.
Up to 75,000 from alcohol and 400,000 from tobacco. There are more than 200 known harmful chemicals in cigarettes. Just think of all the things that those chemicals are doing to the inside of your body, hurting vital organs and making you feel physical pain, which is not good for anyone. Learn about different types of communication, such as demanding, confident, and unsure while talking to someone, as well as how to evade bad situations, like when someone is trying to get you to smoke and you know it's bad for you. It has also taught me different ways to get away from someone that is trying to get you to do something that you know is bad, which is called peer pressure.
DDM, DARE Decision-Making Model, is where you read about someone in a situation and use DARE. Here, DARE stands for Define, Assess, Respond, and Evaluate to find out what the best solution is. However, it is not just for use in school. I have used it in real life. For example, earlier this year, I saw someone getting picked on. I don't think the person who was teasing meant to be rude, but the other child was still uncomfortable. So I decided to step in and tell them to stop. Sure enough, the teacher stopped and apologized. Everything was okay after that, and I even saw them hanging out together the next day. That really showed me how it only takes one voice to make a difference. This ordeal has taught me to be careful. Now I can use this knowledge to be safe and responsible. I never knew how bad drugs and alcohol were for you, so I probably would have made the wrong decision and tried one of them. Also, if I ever get bullied, I'll know what to do. I feel it is a very important life skill that all children should have a chance to learn. All the information our deputy shows will help me lead a better life.
Thank you, Maddox. Thank you, Andrew. Great job, you guys. This might need to be a little bit lower than mine. Thank you, guys. Like I said, the essays were top-notch this year. Couldn't have expected anything better. Everyone in the class made a great essay, wrote top-notch essays, like I said before. It really took me a long time to figure out who won, and I just was amazed at how well everyone did in the essay. Everyone followed the curriculum and actually used their notes on what they were doing and brought it into their own lives as well. So it was just much, much more than I ever expected. So I'm very proud of you guys for doing that. Now I'd like to recognize two additional students who have demonstrated that they are role models to their peers. These students have demonstrated that they are exceptionally kind and hardworking. Both of these students have demonstrated a positive contribution to class every week. Whether these students are at lunch or on the playground or in the classroom or gym class, they display an exceptional attitude. Every time I see them doing something, it's with kindness or leadership or whatever it may be that they're doing. It's just always being a role model for everyone else in the class. So with no further ado, I'd like to welcome Oliver Stoddard and Hannah Carone up to the stage. This time I would like to issue all of the students their graduation certificates. If I could have Ms. Gadwa's class please stand up and have Ms. Sutherland come on stage.
Thank you.
So with that, our graduation is concluded. However, I would like to thank Ms. Utherland and Ms. Gadwalkin for so much all they've done this year. They have been more than helpful in my first year. There's a lot of times where I didn't know really what to do, and they put me forward and got me on the right track, and I can't express enough thanks to them. They were great this year, and with the graduation as well. Ms. Utherland and Mr. McCall, you were great today. I can't express enough thanks. Thank you so much, and I will introduce Mr. McCall for a quick word.
So, when I was sitting here, I realized, you guys are big now. I don't know if the parents back there have the same feeling just a few minutes ago. I was like, wait a minute. I don't remember them being this big about, like, a month ago, I feel like. But, another note, I do want to thank Deputy Tarrant and Sheriff Favreau for coming here today and running a wonderful program, and it really is so important, especially now in our society, that our children see all the positives that people in law enforcement do and how great people that they are. And it's not just someone that you see on a U-turn if you slow down on the Northway. That it's more than that. These are really good people, and so I thank them. I also want to thank Mrs. Sutherland and Ms. Gadwa for everything they have done with their students. I also want to recognize, of course, Calvin is here again, like he is in so many other events. Thank Calvin Kastein. I want to congratulate our students, Oliver and Hannah and Avery and Maddox, for the wonderful job that they did. A round of applause for them. But to our fifth graders, we are also very proud of you, not for today and what you did, or not what you've done in the DARE program, but what you do every day in our school. And we are very proud of all of you. And soon enough, you guys will be in sixth grade, and I can't believe that, but we're very proud. And finally, to the parents, I do thank you all for coming today. I know you have busy lives and busy jobs and bosses and people you gotta talk to get time off. And so we do appreciate that these days that you're here, and so we thank you. And I guess one more big round of applause for everyone at the Sheriff's Department and also for our fifth graders. And that concludes our graduation. And for the parents, if you'd like to stick around a little bit, we'll leave the fifth graders here. So if you want to take a picture with your child, feel free to stick around. And thank you all for coming. Thanks.